Salutations, spooks, spirits, and specters. And welcome back to Clannad, where I'm going to be doing a new route since Kyo has ended. And I feel like I am better prepared for a lot of the jumping around during the early phases of, like, I guess the neutral path, I suppose. The common path, as I believe my friend Legagorn likes to refer to them as. So let us get started on, let's see here, not this page. There we go, skipping class to kick things off. Because on April 15th, Tomoya has to skip class after ignoring Ryo instead of apologizing, because this is the Kotomi route, which I like to refer to as the Return of the King route of all Clannad, because of the ending. So let us get started. I leave the classroom and head over to the old building. I tiptoe my way down the hallway. Most of the classrooms here aren't used anymore. They'd give a culture club one of these rooms if they applied for it, but for now, they're just being left as is. I sneak into one of the empty classrooms unnoticed. I find a chair and sit down, placing my whole weight on it. Beyond the curtainless windows, I see the same sky as always. I go to the trouble of being truant, and all I do is kill time. The air of the empty room absorbs my muttering. When will my life change? Will there come a day when it will change?
Will there come a day when it will all change? No, it's just, will there come a day when it will change?
Someone I knew said that once. That guy must be really effeminate, I think to myself. Then I realize I was the one who said it. I close my eyes. How great things would be if you could fast forward time. Feeling the unrelenting sun on my face, I open my eyes. I've had enough of being in an empty room. I get up and leave the classroom. I aimlessly walk down the stairs. A sliding door down the hallway catches my eye. It's the library. A sign that reads closed hangs from the door. Upon closer inspection, the door is slightly ajar. It grabs my attention, though I couldn't say why. I open the door and step inside. Tall bookshelves and reading tables line the room. A faint breeze carries the fragrance of dust and paper. The curtains flow and flutter as if they're breathing. Beyond that, I see a silhouette. It's a quiet female student wearing a childish hair ornament. The emblem on her chest shows that she's a third year like me. For some reason, she's sitting on the floor. Maybe she feels sick. I walk closer and notice that she's immersed in a book. Is she playing hooky too? Sunahara and I are the only ones who'd be outside the classroom at this time of day. She doesn't notice me and continues reading. But then she suddenly stops, turning the pages. She found something. She takes out a pair of scissors. She positions the blades on a page and stops for a few seconds. It's almost as if she's meditating. And then, snip, 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 she cuts through the book without any more hesitation. Hey, wait!
I run up to her without thinking. She stops and looks at my face. She's barefoot for some reason. Her campus shoes and socks lay on the floor. Surrounding her is a mountain of books and a bag that probably belongs to her. Now that I look more closely, there's even a cushion that she brought from somewhere. Her glare and the relaxed way she's sitting make everything seem unbalanced. That book belongs to the library.
Hmm?
She's thinking of something. Snip, snip, snip.
Hi.
She cuts off the corner of the page she extracted from the book and hands it to me.
はしっこの方が美味しいの。
She's talking about the paper like it's a slice of cake or meat. You eat this? I accept the piece of paper, but I hold it up and question her.
食べないの?焼きじゃないから。
I thought so.
髪食べたい?
I don't want to eat it either.
お腹空いてない?
I'm starting to get hungry.
私もお腹空いてきたの。
Uh-huh. We're making conversation, but nothing seems to make sense. Anyway, I don't think it's good to cut up the school's books. It's out of character for me, but I lecture her. Snip, snip. She's not listening.
Huh?
Never mind. Do what you want. I drop the piece of paper she gave me on the floor. Since I'm here anyway, I glance at the books around her. The thickest book says Astrophysics from Past to Future on the cover. It's one of those books where I wouldn't understand a single word. These books seem too specialized and expensive for a library like this. Looking more closely at the one she's holding, it's stamped Property of Prefectural Library. Huh. It isn't the school's book after all. Hey. I scratched my head. Didn't your parents ever tell you to take care of public property? She's deep in thought again. She takes a box from her bag and pops open the lid.
お弁当. とっても美味しいお弁当.
I didn't ask.
私の手作りなの。 今日のメニューは だし巻き卵と肉じゃがとほうれん草と煮豆なの。 特にこの辺が自信作。
She points at the contents of the container. It does look good. If I remember correctly, no food or drink is allowed in the library. Never mind that. We should be in class right now.
食べる?
Look here.
今日のは粘土じゃないから。
You usually eat lunches made of clay?
食べないの? お腹壊すから。 粘土 食べたい?
I don't want to eat clay either.
お腹空いてない?
I'm starting to get hungry.
私もお腹空いてきたの。
Our conversation isn't going anywhere and almost seems to be repeating itself. Hold on, I'm...
食べる?
She looks straight into my eyes and asks me again.
Taperu?
There's a hint of loneliness in her voice. The breeze from the window floats across her childish hair ornament. It makes me feel guilty for some reason. And you just nom nom nom. I'll take a little. She nods with a sigh of relief.
いただきましょう. いただきます.
She puts her hands together and bows.
あんして.
Ah. Hey, I can't do this. It's embarrassing and we just met. She doesn't seem... hold on here. Pause. She doesn't seem to understand what's embarrassing about it. And this is, I guess, where we'll have to end it. Since the timer just went off. So thank you all very much for watching. And welcome to the Kotomi route. If you kind of noticed on the load screen, I am much better prepared. So when I get to the parts where it's just kind of like commonplace, we don't have to worry about too much dissolving. I just can just jump straight to where I need to go. So, yep. See you guys next time. And ciao for now. Ciao for now.